Welcome back to tonight's debate. For the two at-large seats on the New Orleans City Council, candidates will now ask questions to each other. We began with Mr. Von Uti. We will start this time with Mr. Gant. Your question for the candidate of your choice.
I'm going to throw this out. Anybody can grab it who they want. How, I hear a lot about the reduction of crime. What's your idea specifically about reducing crime in the city of New Orleans?
I'll take it. I think, number one, you've got to make sure that at the neighborhood level, every district has all of the manpower, all of the resources, and all the vehicles that it deserves. Secondly, we need to go back to accountability and responsiveness using a zone strategy that was highly successful in the past, where the same officers, the same vehicles, patrol the same community and build relationships of trust and confidence. Also, hire and put in an effective position the police monitor.
Mr. Philco, your chance to ask a question.
Okay, I'm going to ask Mr. Marshall a question. Nolan, we, as you may know, we used to be the very best in the country in recreation, and recreation plays such a vital role in reducing crime, in economic development, and keeping our community safe and healthy. Would you agree that we need some change and some reform, and would you support the current proposal that will recreate a governance structure and create a public-private partnership and also earmark dedicated funding to NORD?
I do agree. I've spent the past 4 years working on criminal justice reform, and that's just one part of the problem. If you look at the way that we funded NORD over the past 10 years, as the funding for NORD has gone down, the crime rate has gone up. So we absolutely have to find a way to fund it. Currently, we're funding it at $3 million. Baton Rouge is spending $40 million. That's a direct indication of where our priorities are as a community. And unless we start investing in the young people in this town, we're not going to be able to move it forward, and we're not going to be able to do anything about the crime problem.
Mr. Saunier, your chance to ask a question.
Sure. This is going towards Cynthia Willard-Lewis. Cynthia, you've been in government now for, I would say, a little over 15 years, and you have been a district council person for 8 years in District E. After the storm, I came back with the good faith of opening my restaurant or at a business that was licensed to be or occupationally licensed to have a restaurant there. Here it is. And that's been issued over 10 years period of time. With it says restaurant.
Let's get to the question.
Okay. It says restaurant with table service. Nonetheless, is it acceptable for the city of New Orleans, because the city council spends 80% of their time on zoning issues, is it acceptable for the city of New Orleans to change this license that's been issued for 10 years to something else that doesn't mean anything?
Well, relative to zoning changes and issues of the use of land and or the development of land, the entire community is moving forward with the master plan, which will also have a comprehensive zoning ordinance. So concerning your problem of the past, moving forward, Mrs. Sonia, it will be solved once the master plan with the comprehensive zoning ordinance with the citizen participation component are all adopted and the voice of the people is heard and folded into that. So whatever occurred in the past will be corrected in the future.
Willard-Lewis, you only get one question. Sorry. Ms. Willard-Lewis, your opportunity to ask a question to the candidate of your choice.
Well, following up on that discussion with the master plan, I'm going to ask Ms. Clarkson, relative to the master plan, which will soon be coming to the council, the master plan, absent the development of the comprehensive zoning ordinance and the citizen participation plan, will you push for the adoption of the plan without the zoning ordinance as well as the citizen participation plan?
Jackie. Well, Ms. Willard-Lewis, Cynthia, as the author of the master plan with the comprehensive zoning code with the force of law, we will push for what was passed by the vote of the people. And that's the whole idea of a charter change, is the vote of the people. And what the vote of the people voted for and it passed by a majority, that's the process we will follow. There will be more open meetings when it comes, it's with the Planning Commission now. When it comes to the City Council, we have already discussed, as you know, as recovery co-chairs with Mr. Philco, the president, that we will have a public open meeting to begin it in recovery in the council chambers. We'll have meetings, minimum one in every district of the city, and then bring it back to the council chambers for any final meetings we need, then send it to the full council and any additional meetings we need. And yes, we will complete the plan and proceed with the comprehensive zoning code. As a 40-year realtor, we have nothing more important right now.
Thank you. Your question, Ms. Clarkson.
Okay. I'm going to ask Mr. Saunier, the knowing your zoning problem and having represented a lot of young business owners, small business owners in my real estate days, there is a very vague interpretation a lot of times on zoning. And that's one of the reasons it was so important to me that we pass a master plan with the force of law, with the comprehensive zoning code, so we're all playing from the same game book, as you will. I mean, the NFL wouldn't play if anyone wouldn't play in the NFL if they changed the rules in the middle of the game.
Or make the rules up as we go.
So what's the question?
Right. So the question is, have you read the master plan, or will you commit to reading it with me, for me, an answer, so we'll know that we have solved that problem from a typical business investor standpoint?
Nobody here will come to this city and open a business or a small business unless the building they occupy is spelled out exactly what they can and cannot do. As a businessman, I looked at the occupational license that said, gee, maybe I could do this because it's been issued for 10 years. And in hindsight, all of a sudden, I should have gone down, I don't know to who at the time, because this was after the storm, of who to see what can you do here. But it's all gray area. The master plan needs to be completed to where there's no gray area. Business won't come here unless we have written down exactly the rules of the game. We can't make the rules up as we go.
Mr. Marshall, you get to ask a question.
Ms. Clarkson, mm-hmm. You knew my grandfather, yes. And like he was, I'm a young African-American leader in the community.
Yes.
Our community has issues with poverty. Our community still has issues with violent crime. Our community still has issues with infrastructure. With all due respect, you've served in city government for 20 years. Mm-hmm. At what point in time do we move on and allow new leadership to solve some of these problems?
In 4 more years, Mr. Marshall, because then I'll be finished. And I and thank you for acknowledging that I knew your grandfather, because I loved and admired and respected him. And yes, but I've only been in city government. 8 of those years I was in state government. And we have addressed a lot of those problems. Have you seen the Fisher housing development? We reduced poverty and crime tenfold there. And very proudly, I got to lead that as the district council person to make that difference in that particular community. And from 90 to 94 as a district councilwoman, I was very proud to create the private-public partnership then that rebuilt half the playgrounds in this city, and we did begin to curb juvenile crime. Katrina unfortunately destroyed that, and I do believe we have to come back with something more permanent than that form we used then to assure us against another Katrina. So, yes, I have played a significant role in reducing poverty and in reducing crime.
Thank you. Mr. Von Uti, you got a question.
I would like to throw this question out in the context that, as someone who can be elected to council at large as a Republican, knowing that our 3 surrounding parishes are predominantly Republican and our state government is Republican with a Republican governor, and there seems to be some type of filter between New Orleans and Baton Rouge, I would like to know why the winds of change can't be accepted. What makes the current Democratic administration, knowing that we are a predominantly Democratic city, feel that they can create a better dialogue to Baton Rouge in trying to get some recovery started, because we've been in limbo?
Who would you like to ask that question?
I'm throwing it out to any of the incumbents.
I think a good independent.
Mr. Fieldcock.
I think especially post-Katrina, you know, we've got as much as we can to get away from partisan politics. Obviously, we can look to Washington and just see the dysfunction that occurs at that level when you've got politics on both sides playing. I have to tell you, we're all in this together right now. New Orleans, in 4.5 years after Katrina, are the most resilient group of people that one could imagine. As a city, it's going to be extremely important for us. The next mayor and this council, along with whomever is representing us in a legislative capacity, go to Baton Rouge before the session, go around the state before the session, meet the 144 legislators, know what their needs are in their communities, and talk about our needs honestly. We have not put forward, in my opinion, a very good legislative agenda at the state level the last few years. It needs to be done in advance. It needs to be done with consultation. And I believe we can do that, and I think it will solve a lot of the partisanship that goes on. We still have issues in Louisiana, as does Illinois and others.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank all of you very much. We have to take another break now, but don't go anywhere, because when we come back, more questions from you, the viewers.